Calling themselves peace builders, six young Chicagoans from neighborhoods affected by violence traveled to Nicaragua in June 2015. Hosted by local community leaders, they continued their studies on how people and communities recover from violence and work together to spread the message of peace. Since 1991, Los Quinchos has rescued thousands of children living on the streets of Nicaraguan cities. Born into communities devastated by years of war, economic isolation, and extreme poverty, most have been abused, neglected, or abandoned by their families. Many sniff highly addictive glue to alleviate hunger and dull the pain of separation. At its residential facilities, including a farm in San Marcos, privately funded Los Quinchos provides care, educational support, arts and vocational programs, and psychological counseling. Former Quinchos act as intake workers, mentors, and leaders in this unique community.
Hay que entender de que el consumo de pegamento no a todos les va a dar el mismo efecto. Eso depende mucho de la situación, el origen. Nadie va a la calle a inhalar pega si no hay un antecedente. ¿Qué significa esto? Normalmente está en la familia. Sí, algo quería agregar nada más, que por ejemplo, si ustedes miran el fenómeno social nicaragüense en los niños, ellos les han sido mutilados su infancia. Desde los padres, desde la familia, desde la misma sociedad en general, les ha mutilado la infancia. ¿Qué es lo que hacemos nosotros? Démosle la infancia. Viví tu infancia que no has vivido. Y entonces ahí es donde está el secreto del trabajo.
Just being here in the finca, they do so much with so little, and it has taught me to really appreciate life for the small things. They really know how to appreciate everything. You know, they have so much love to give, and I think that's something I really want to take back home and share with my community. They built a community with nothing, and they've maintained it and made it last, and it's wonderful, and I really love that. And you know, all the different opportunities provided for children, you know, such as hammock making, they teach them how to dance, music. You know, music is wonderful, everyone loves music, so giving the kids something that they love and something to connect to, it really, you know, makes them want to stay here, and it makes them feel like they're at home and they can be themselves. And it's important to be yourself, you know, when building a community. And it lets children know that they are accepted for who they are.
I met Kevin. When we was in the field together, I pointed to the bracelet to figure out, like, was there, like, any more? And he took it off his ankle and he put it on mine gladly. And I explained to him how it affected me because where I'm from, people don't do that. Like, if you want something, you have to go out and go make it yourself or do it yourself. And I shed a few tears on that. And that bond right there won't be taken away by anybody.
Que si una persona quiere tener lo que uno tiene, pues aquí hacemos eso, dárselo. Y si lo quiere tener él por mucho tiempo, se lo dejamos. Se lo regalamos para que lo tenga él y que lo cuide mucho.
I didn't think they would have such an impact on me until the last day that we had to leave, and there was this one kid in particular. He really touched my heart. He was actually the only kid that I saw that wasn't playing, and he was always off by himself. And I thought that was strange, and so I kind of got close to him and I started talking to him, and I realized that he hadn't been there too long, so maybe that's why he was off by himself and not with everyone else. And before we left, I had told him that I loved him, that I really cared about him, and he started to cry. And that made me really sad.
Aparte lo que a mí me dieron, que soy un ex quincho, de que me agarraron de 6 años, entonces ahora me siento con el derecho o el deber, ¿verdad? Trabajar con ella, entonces el amor que a mí me dieron, que no encontré en la calle, pero sí encontré aquí en Los Quinchos, ahora yo lo estoy dando a este proyecto.
I think that the ex-quinchos working as mentors and instructors in Los Quinchos right now is really important because they've experienced what it's like to live that type of life. They've been in their shoes, they know what they're talking about, and the Quinchos need someone like that. I know that I wouldn't like someone to tell me, you know, this is how you should live your life if they haven't been in my situation.
el haber sido exquincho me y haber estado en la misma situación por la que muchos niños están pasando ahora, es como un arma para mí, porque yo sé tratar a esos niños y los trato como me trataron a mí, como yo hubiese querido que me trataran.
It's important to me to be a mentor for these kids, not only for these kids in other communities, but the kids in my community, the people in the Restoration Project, for them to trust me completely where they could come up to me with their problems.
Y cuando termines acá, ¿qué es tu plan? ¿Qué es tu plan cuando termines acá? ¿Tú qué quieres hacer cuando termines acá con los quinchos? ¿Qué quieres hacer este de tu profesión?
Ser profesor. Trabajar aquí.
Okay, trabajar aquí. He wants to work here still when he's older. So he wants to stay here and help the children as well.
Eight villagers lost their lives when the peaceful farming community of El Lagartillo was attacked by U.S.-backed Contra fighters on December 31, 1984. As part of its rebuilding and healing process, the village built a hilltop memorial to those killed, established the Spanish language school incorporating homestays, and founded highly regarded theater and music programs. Villagers welcome visitors to experience their simple, peaceful lifestyle and commitment to responsible, sustainable agriculture.
The way the community is now is based on that experience in 1984. So youth that haven't experienced it before, they're able to understand why they live the way they do and why it's important to be united as a community, or else they wouldn't be able to understand and connect back to their roots and kind of like their history. People like to look back at that time as a traumatic event, but at the same time as a place of hope and resilience.
El monumento aquí tiene un significado muy, muy, muy especial para la comunidad. Es rindiendo honor a los seis caídos que cayeron el 31 de diciembre de 1984. Después de la masacre, todos quedamos con mucho dolor. Teníamos un bloqueo económico y nuestra comida se quemó el día de la masacre y tuvimos una crisis económica fuerte. Y algunas veces y algunas personas teníamos desánimo por días que queríamos como claudicar, no continuar, pero pensábamos en ellos, ¿no? No, ellos murieron por nosotros, nosotros debemos continuar y seguir hacia adelante. Entonces, yo siento que ellos fue nuestro empuje, nuestra inspiración, nuestra motivación.
The younger generations have learned that from the older ones, and those who died here didn't die in vain. I suppose that's a strong inspiration for them to build a better community over the years.
In this community, the people has really grown to love and to embrace each other as if they were all relatives. It just makes the community feel more together, and it makes it feel more beloved, and this is what other communities need to have to make a better future for others and for the next generations.
They're doing something to create more peaceful communities, and it's starting with teaching their children that violence is not okay.
La paz es una... es amor, y pienso que debe empezar desde querernos nosotros mismos, ¿no? Desde nuestra casa con nuestros hijos, desde no comprarle, es muy personal esto, desde no comprarle un juguete violento a un niño, pienso que ahí empezamos por hacer la paz, ¿no? Desde nuestra casa, nuestra familia y nuestro mismo ser, ¿no? Yo me quiero como soy, desde ahí podemos empezar a hacer la paz nosotros en cualquier parte del mundo.
Especialmente vivir una vida más simple, más sencilla, ¿no? Sin pensar mucho en lo material, más una vida más humana también, que se lleven eso, ¿no? De nuestra cultura aquí.
Paz, paz, paz. Paz por siempre, paz, aquí en Nicaragua, y en todo lugar.
I think it was important for me to come here to just experience something new and to learn from different cultures and just to see how, even though we are worlds apart, we are very similar in a way, and we're not that different. And we all go through the same problems, no matter where we're from.
Aprendimos a relacionarnos con diferentes personas. También ellos nos transmitieron acerca de lo que ellos hacían, acerca de lo importante que es la paz para un país, para la comunidad.
Nos transmitieron muchísimas cosas porque esperamos que hayan aprendido mucho de nosotros, al igual que nosotros aprendimos muchísimo de ustedes. Nos transmitieron pues su idea de paz en su país y esperamos pues que podamos hacer eso nosotros con nuestro país a la vez.
Entonces, es decir, si ustedes quieren, ¿verdad?, hacer un trabajo de concientización, yo te decía, tienen que tener más que todo continuamente reunirse, hablar de la conciencia, siempre hablar de que ustedes tienen que ser mejores, que tienen que cada día avanzar y no retroceder, porque a veces hay debilidades en la persona, siente como difícil hacerla, voy a seguir, ¿verdad?, luchando, pero no, continuamente uno tiene que luchar hasta que pueda llegar, dijo, a consolidar bien su por lo menos los grupos que ustedes están trabajando.
We're kind of going along this path, thinking that in San Marcos and here in El Lagartillo, I see the same type of sense of community. It's the sense of community that has kept these people together and has kept them away from conflict and striving towards a more peaceful environment.
It's just these stories of hope and forgiveness and resilience. I think those are the most important to speak of because there's a lot of problems in our communities and we sometimes just, it becomes a normal part of our lives that, you know, we forget that these things shouldn't be normal and that we should do something to fix these problems. We shouldn't just let them keep on going. A lot of people also don't believe in change, and so I think sharing the stories of Los Quinchos and the stories of this community in El Lagartillo will help people understand that peace is actually possible, and even in times of like trauma and violence, that people can still come together and create the change that they want to see if they just work together and love each other, even though it might sound impossible and almost kind of cheesy. It's actually true, and I feel like we're already starting to do that in the community that I work with in Little Village.
In this community, when we get visitors who come here, we always look at it as a way of exchanging. I like very much your idea of peace exchange, because when people come here, we learn from each other, we exchange each other's experience, each other's point of view. And although we might think, oh, well, it's a different, such a different background. I mean, it's a rural, small rural community where everyone knows each other. We hardly close the doors, lock the doors in our house. And you live in an urban area, which is probably sometimes more hostile. And when you go out in the streets, you worry, oh, where are my kids going? And there's much, much traffic and so on. But we're still so human, so human nature is there. We're all trying to find ways to be happy, and definitely building peace is the way to do it, the way to go about it.
Tristes las flores por la flor de la corte, los jazmines de oriente, los nelumbos del norte, de occidente las dalias y las rosas del sur. Pobrecita princesa, preciosa, de los ojos azules. Está presa en sus oros, está presa en sus tules, en la jaula de mármol del Palacio Real, el palacio soberbio que vigilan los guardas, que custodian 100 negros con sus 100 alabardas, un lebrel que no duerme y un dragón colosal. ¡Oh! ¿Quién fue Hipsípila que dejó la crisálida? La princesa está triste, la princesa está pálida. ¡Oh, visión adorada de oro, rosa y marfil! ¿Quién volará a la tierra donde un príncipe existe? La princesa está pálida, la princesa está triste. Más brillante que el alba, más hermoso que abril. ¡Calla, shh, calla, shh! Princesa, dice la madrina. En caballo con alas hacia acá se encamina, en el cinto la espada y en la mano el azor. El feliz caballero que te abra sin verte y que llega de lejos vencedor de la muerte a encenderte los labios con su beso de amor.